All right, guys, we can cut right to the chase here. You've both had a chance to review this.
Why don't we cut right to the chase? One second, Mr. COO. I think everybody here knows that this match is pretty much already official. I mean, John Cena versus CM Punk at SummerSlam. Everybody knows where we're going with this. So why are we out here? This is all just for show, right? We're supposed to be out here and be entertaining. I mean, when's the last time we had one of these contract signings that didn't end in some sort of horrible physical calamity with... So if you want to cut to the chase, you know, we can flip the table over and we can all start beating each other up, or we can just at least make this entertaining. I feel like I'm a movie star and I'm on the set of, you know, maybe Conan O'Brien or something. I'm about to pitch a clip to my next big movie, and in that vein, I actually have a clip from a big-time movie star that is going to explain in so many words how I feel about John Cena. And no, that movie star isn't you in The Chaperone.
How was your movie, by the way? Oh, I missed it.
Mine went straight to DVD, just like yours. This is an actual movie star who is now going to explain how I feel mostly about you. So take it away, Dwayne.
Here's why John Cena is angry. It's the same process every single night in every arena around the world. You're in your locker room, John. You're getting dressed. You're putting on your little tough guy sneakers. You're sliding on your jean shorts. Yeah, your tough guy jean shorts that nobody's worn since 1992, but that's okay. No, but that's okay. But then, you're putting on your red wristbands, tough guy wristbands, and you put them up here. Oh, more strength and power you get. Yeah, like a superhero. And it says, you can't shame me. Yeah, yeah, you're looking like a bloated transvestite Wonder Woman, ready to fight crime. Pew, 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 pew. Then it gets even worse. Your music hits. You go running down, yeah, running down like a lost snagglepuss. You slide in the ring, you throw your hat, you take off your shirt, yeah, yeah. Oh, you're full of energy and fire, and then your music stops. You hear something, John, that eats away at your very soul. Eats away at your very core. You hear this in every arena around the world. It kills you because you know you're gonna hear it for life.
Let's go, Cena!
Cena sucks! You know why you go to your own hometown in Boston and they boo you? You know why? The Rock will tell you why. Because The Rock is a man. And The Rock represents a majority of men around the world. We don't like you, we don't respect you. Why? Because we, us men, see through bull, and we smell a phony punk a mile away.
There's a lot wrong with that. I mean, obviously, I don't think they're saying Cena sucks. I think they're saying CM Punk. But you get the gist of it, right? And for everything that's right with that, thank you, Dwayne, for sending that from your Facebook, by the way. You're a phony, like he says, but the ironic thing is, while he's calling you a phony, he doesn't realize he's just as big a phony as you are. And maybe Dwayne's gonna be upset now, but he seems to have a real problem with you. I don't want Dwayne to talk to me in a voice like this and say mean things about me, so maybe I'll just stop and I'll sign the contract.
No. See, this is what you were talking about, being entertaining. I like the stuff. You caught me off guard a little bit with the clip. But listen to this. You have these people going crazy, and that's what I love to see. You see, a guy like that, a guy like Dwayne The Rock Johnson. I mean, this guy has done it all. Future WWE Hall of Famer, absolutely. Headlining WrestleMania, he's already on the bill. a bona fide Hollywood movie star. This guy is working on G.I. Joe right now as we speak. Congratulations, Dwayne. Here's the thing. With all the success he's had, there is no reason for a guy like that to be mad about anything, because I'm sure he's doing just fine. Yet he looks at me, and he just flips out. He gets so angry. And why? Because you heard him. Because I wear red. I'm some sort of transvestite Wonder Woman Fruity Pebble. Because my jorts are 20 years out of style. Because I tie my shoes wrong. Because of the way I wear my cap.
Okay. I didn't show the clip so you could go off on the rock.
No. That's okay. Because you also have an issue with me. Now, you're not going to make fun of the way I dress. I believe you're above that. But your issues are those of the voiceless. You think maybe I'm a product of the system. Maybe that I'm, even though I know kids are watching, maybe I'm a little too PG for you. Maybe I'm just the modern day Hulk Hogan. I just took the hand away from my ear, brother, and put it in front of my face. This is where I hit you with some truth.
I like truth.
The Rock is a star, and he has his millions. And I could try my hardest to talk trash with The Rock, to battle back and forth with The Rock. I will never win over the millions. And you, of course, you have your fans. And I know no matter what I do, I could increase my work rate. I could add to the five moves of doom, or maybe let my heel persona shine through. I will never win over those people. You made an amazing comparison to me a few weeks back. You said I was the New York Yankees. I originally was offended by that, but the Yankees are the most loved and hated team in all of professional sport. Listen. I can just bring up the name, and it gets a response. And you, in that comparison, were absolutely right. Listen, there are so, so many people that hate me. Just like The Rock said, when my music plays and I run down that ramp, it's like those Hall of Fame championship riddled pinstripes taking the field. People just see it and they ooze hate. Those are not the people I'm concerned with. I'm concerned with those who wear their colors proud. I am concerned with the people who have been loyal and devoted to me and know no matter what, I will not give up on them through thick or thin, good, bad, or indifferent. Those are the people I care about. You speak your mind and you throw a lot of stones and you live in a glass house. Because you a few weeks ago wanted your own private jet. You want to be on the front of magazines. You wanted your own movies. Your face on ice cream bars. Yes, indeed. I'd even have a CM Punk ice cream bar, but now you're trying to come back as some underground voice of the voiceless? You want phony punk? Look in the mirror, kid.
All you are at the end of the day is a guy that held out for more money and a couple of perks, right? And then you didn't even have the guts to stand face to face like a man and negotiate for him. You ran away and called on the phone.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm gutless? I'm a phony? I'm gutless? Let's analyze that. Who fires people around here? You or Funk Man over here, huh? Who? Let me ask you a question, Johnny. Funk Man? Did you personally, face-to-face, fire Vladimir Kozlov on Friday, huh? Did you fly yourself to Florida to tell Harry Smith, yes, his name is Harry, not David Hart Smith, that he was no longer needed here? Huh? Did you tell Chris Masters somebody who over the past year has worked his ass off to get better. Did you fire him face to face, or did you call him up and say, hey kid, it's a budget thing, best of luck in your future endeavors? Don't call me gutless. You have him do your dirty work. This isn't about him. This isn't about you. This is about you, and this is about me, and this is about the WWE Championship. And it's easy for you to sit there and act all noble and holier than thou when you've been afforded opportunity after opportunity. See, you're placed on a pedestal, so your perspective is skewed. You look down on everybody else. You look down on me. And I'll give you an example. Some odd years ago, I won my first championship here in the WWE. I won the ECW title. The next day, you, who didn't bother saying two words to me before that, pat me on the back and you said, good match, congratulations, champ. I almost gave up on you. I hold grudges. Ever since then, I've had a sour taste in my mouth because who the hell do you think you are? You gave up on me? Huh? You know who gave up Mr. Hustle, loyalty, and respect? You know who gave up on their dream? You did. When you moved to California to become a bodybuilder and you became a sports entertainer because you couldn't hack it. All right? I started as a professional wrestler and I fought to get to where I'm at right now. And yeah, I held up the WWE for some perks. Do I want an ice cream bar with my name on it? You're damn right. You see, you're the lion. I'm the hyena. I gotta fight for my share. So yeah, I held everybody up to get the opportunities that you've just been handed, the opportunities that you've just been given, that yeah, you can take. I mean, who would turn them down? Certainly I wouldn't. 7 years ago in Los Angeles, you walked in and you won your first WWE title. Congratulations. This Sunday, you're walking back into Los Angeles, and I want to let you know something. You're walking out with nothing. You are walking out with nothing. Oh, sure, you'll be a big star the next day. You'll be in the Marine Corps, or maybe you'll have your big fight with Dwayne, which is great, and you'll still have your legions of fans who are going to pee in their pajamas every time they think about you. You know what you're not going to have, John Boy? You're not going to have the WWE Championship. You will not be WWE Champion, because the WWE Champion will be me.
Fine speech. Do you realize how much pressure is on you this Sunday? No. Do you have no idea? Congratulations, Punk. You won one match in Chicago at Money in the Bank. You did a hell of a job. You beat me straight out. You have every right to be called the WWE Champion. You ever thought about what happens if you just might lose at SummerSlam? Your little diatribe about me going on and facing Dwayne The Rock Johnson at WrestleMania is exactly correct. Win, lose, or draw, I'm headed to WrestleMania to face The Rock. You need this match. You need this more than anything in your life, because you now have people watching you. You have explained that that is a pipe bomb, and you speak your mind, and I commend you for that. But if you don't back it up when the bell rings, especially this Sunday, you know what you are? You're a loudmouth, one-hit wonder. You. You will be known as Buster Douglas, Yahoo Serious, Millie, what's the other guy? Vanilli. If you don't produce on Sunday with everything on the line, for you, all of this, gone, just like that. Good luck.
Good luck, John. Luck's for losers, and I would much rather be a one-hit wonder than a phony.
We've been talking for quite a while now, and you came out here to entertain these people, right? I just got a feeling this talking thing is wearing a bit thin.
Well, hey, you know, talking's sort of what I do, but I can also kick your teeth down your throat.
SummerSlam, there will only be one undisputed WWE champion.